On Channel 4, someone who knows a bit about time travel, David Tennant, is tonight's guest host in the Friday Night Project, which contains strong language.
Grolsch, time for something original.
Come on in.
Today, David Tennant returned to this London studio.
Boys. I'm back.
Not only is he Doctor Who.
Oh.
It's going to be a cracking show.
Oh, it's going to be good.
And Scotland's most loved son. But he's back for a second crack.
Oh, I love Philip Fan.
And hosting...
So, French President Nicolas Sarkozy and his gorgeous ex-model wife, Carla Bruni, made a state visit to Britain this week. There was a moment of unease when Prince Philip mentioned wife swapping. Then even more raised eyebrows later when France's First Lady made a slight faux pas with her choice of dress for dinner. I can see her corgi. So it's official, Ricky and Bianca returning to EastEnders. We have an exclusive picture of the lovely moment when they're reunited for the first time in 9 years. In fact, my mates who work on the show have told me it's all part of the BBC's plan to bring viewers back to Albert Square. Next, they're planning to get Pat Butcher to sex up her image a bit. So, please welcome tonight's musical guests. They really are fantastic. It's the Wombats!
David Tennant, everybody! David Tennant, you sexy bastard. Isn't he hot? Isn't he hot? Has there ever been a sexier Doctor Who?
Tom Baker.
William Hartnell.
Oh, yeah. Sylvester McCoy. He is good.
Now, the new series is about to start, isn't it, in the next couple of weeks?
It's a week. Week tomorrow, April the 5th.
Expect from the new series?
Well, you can expect thrills and spills, as you would have come to expect. There's just lots of really good stories, and there's Catherine Tate. Who is quite simply brilliant as Donna Noble. Returning, she was on the show, there she is, she was on the show a couple of Christmases back, and she now comes back full time. And she's fantastic.
The full-time assistant.
She's there for the whole series.
Now, is she doing it as Nan? Because that's what I'd like to say. Doctor.
Yeah. Can you see
that?
Yeah, yeah.
Does she do a little bit of that? These fucking darlings.
Now, that would be great. Does she do that?
She's a fully rounded character.
Shall we have a look at a clip from the new series?
Yeah, why not?
Shall we? Let's have a look.
I go down in that, they'll just call us back up again.
No, because the lock the controls of the sonic cage, I'm the only one who can control it. Not unless she's got a sonic device of her own, which is very unlikely.
Out of my way.
David, we've heard a rumour that in one episode from the new series, all of your former assistants are going to be together for the first time in one episode. Is that true?
Yes, it is true. Oh, we are going to see. Yes. Yeah, we're going to see. I'm in the middle of a big, lovely lady sandwich there. Triple decker of delights. Look at that.
Look at that.
It's going to be like loose women in a tardy.
Well, yeah, because John Barrowman comes on as well.
Oh, sorry.
David, have you seen any of the, let's call it, who porn that's on? Now, this is an actual posting. Is that what you call it when you put a message up on the web?
Is it? Yeah. I don't know, but Ben's been typing with one hand when you read what that filth says.
One-handed be dressing.
Oh, no, don't.
Oh. Right, this is good. This is this. Posted by a Doctor Who fan on a Doctor Who porn website.
On a Doctor Who porn website?
I am interested. I'll give you the web address after. The doctor began to caress the nape of Martha's hungry back. He stiffened. More and more, until the longing became too much to bear, and he simply just had to have her.
Well, that's a little inappropriate, isn't it?
Wrong, you think that's bad? Listen to this.
Captain Jack lunged forward with the power and strength that the doctor had always so admired and took him in his manly arms. His hands moved down towards his groin. Show, I can't say that word, can I? It's disgusting.
That one is John Barrowman's blog, though, I think.
David, this is, of course, the second time you've hosted the show.
It is.
We're like family now.
Yeah.
And you chose to take us somewhere all loving families should go.
Yeah, well, I mean, even the most loving families have got to work through some issues, haven't they? So
absolutely.
I took us to an actual family therapist for a good session to make sure our bonds of love were as strong as possible.
Welcome. As you know, today we're going to embark on some group therapy to broaden and deepen your relationship. And the way we normally start a group is just by saying hello to each other. So I'm Cecilia, I'm the therapist today.
I'm Alan.
Hello, Alan.
I'm Justin.
Hello, Justin.
Hi, David.
Hello, David.
Hello. Are we allowed to touch?
He's always like this.
Right. The very first thing we're going to do today is group perception.
Group perception.
To know is to love.
So now I'd like you to pick an object from the table that best represents you. Alan, would you like to go first? Your thoughts, David?
I think... you know, it makes me feel like Alan's as kind of a superhero.
Our next exercise is about building trust. How do you feel about that?
Yeah.
Ready. Building trust bridges.
Physical trust, but emotional trust.
This is your moment to put your trust in David.
Thank you.
Alan,
he was
exactly where he needed to
be.
It's
like catching an eel.
Yes. Do you think that David could have caught the whirlwind that is you?
Well, now you put it like that, love, I don't know.
You are a whirlwind. Do you not realise that?